My job is to talk to you about artificial intelligence. And I think the reason that there's so much enthusiasm around AI is that it's starting to feel like it's everywhere and that it's about to change everything. Here's a thought experiment for AI. This is the one that we use most to help large organizations think about how would they start developing an AI strategy. The way we do this is think about a dial, a knob. And the knob is prediction accuracy. And the thought experiment is going to be taking the knob and turning it. So let's do something that everybody here is probably familiar with, which is shopping on Amazon. Just so I can have a sense, how many people have actually bought something on the Amazon website? Raise your hand. Okay. Virtually everybody. So this is just a screenshot of when you're searching on Amazon. These are things that Amazon was recommending that the shopper purchase. So the recommendation engine inside the Amazon shopping platform is an AI, and it's predicting what it thinks you might want. Now, the way that we do this today is that when we go to Amazon, as everybody here who raised their hand knows, is you go on the website, you search around for stuff, you find things you want, you buy them, you put them in your basket, you pay for them, then that order goes to a fulfillment center somewhere, and somebody in an Amazon warehouse gets your order, they go around, they pick the stuff up that you've ordered, they put it in a box, and it gets shipped to your house. Okay, that's the way it goes. The shorthand for this is you can think that the model that Amazon uses is you shop and then they ship. Okay, shop, then ship. Here's the thought experiment. Now turn the prediction dial. Imagine that recommendation engine gets better and better. For me personally, right now, when I shop at Amazon, it gets it right about 5% of the time, which is not bad. There's millions and millions of things in their catalog, and yet out of every 20 things it recommends to me, I buy one of them. But imagine turning the knob. So instead of getting 1 out of 20, they get 2 out of 20, 5 out of 20, 10 out of 20, 15 out of 20. There's some number, in the words of Spinal Tap, you know, turn this thing to 11. You crank the prediction accuracy knob, what happens? Imagine that they get so good at predicting what I want that somebody in Amazon finally says, wait a minute. Why are we even waiting for this person to order it? Let's just ship it to them, and then when it arrives on their doorstep, they can decide. Now you might say, well, why would you do that? And I would respond, why wouldn't you do it? Because think about it. There's two big advantages for changing the model from shopping, then shipping, to shipping, then shopping. The first advantage is that Amazon prevents you from buying that particular item from a competitor because it's just arrived on your doorstep before you even really realize you wanted it. Secondly, there are many times that we want something, we think, oh yeah, when I get a chance, I'll go on Amazon and buy it, and we don't. Just the hassle of going through and shopping for it prevents us from buying, the friction prevents us from buying it. But if it arrives on our doorstep, we'll take it. So Amazon increases its share of wallet substantively. So much so that as you turn the dial, there's some point where Amazon says, I know that they're going to return some of this stuff, but it's worth it for us to have a greater share of wallet to handle the increased number of returns. Okay. Furthermore, Amazon might do that even before the dial is turned far enough to make it economically worthwhile, because they know the dial's turning. They're investing in turning that dial every day. So they might make the move preemptively, knowing that the sooner they do it, the more data they'll get, the better the AI will be, the better the AI is, the more users they'll get, and they'll get to their nirvana faster.